Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Dana and today I thought I would share with you some very simple cottage Christmas vintage inspired DIYs. They're very easy. I hope that you guys enjoy this video. We're gonna start off with the cutest, most rustic looking gingerbread garland. Very easy to make, and I love the way that this turned out. Okay, so for the gingerbread DIY garland, we're going to need flour, salt, cocoa powder, water, and cinnamon. It doesn't get much easier than mixing all of the ingredients in a bowl with a fork until you get a crumbly dough. You will then form it into a ball and roll it out anywhere from an eighth of an inch to a quarter of an inch thick, and then using a small gingerbread cookie cutter, cutting out the gingerbread men. Now, as you can see throughout this, mine, I didn't mix probably as well as I should have, so there's a little variation in the color. I personally don't mind that because I feel like it gives it a little bit more of a rustic look, but if you don't like that, just mix it a little bit better and that color will even out and mix right into the dough. Next, you will just place all the gingerbread men on a parchment lined baking sheet, and they bake at 275 degrees for 2 hours. That was all I needed to make sure that these had hardened completely. But when you take them out after 2 hours, if after sitting for 30 minutes they're not completely hard, you would just go ahead and bake them for another half hour. But like I said, 2 hours was plenty for me to bake these. Through this dark
the last step. Before I baked them, I just took a straw to make holes into the hands or arms of each of the gingerbread men. This is where I will string the yarn through to make the garland.
And that's the magic of Christmas to me.
So you can see after I pull them out, they get a little bit of a white cast. That is just from the salt in the dough. To get rid of that, you just take a neutral oil, canola oil or avocado oil, and brush it on each gingerbread man. What I like is I could flip it over and find which side I liked better. And then once you're done brushing the oil on all of them, it brings the color back out. You can just use a paper towel to blot any extra oil off and to get rid of any shine. Next, I cut 6 feet of a cotton rope. I only had this 3-piece cotton rope that's kind of twisted together, so I just untwisted it to get one of the strands. And then just using a really thick, like, yarn needle, I don't really know exactly what it's called, you go ahead and thread the holes that you made with a straw before you baked them through each gingerbread man and onto the string to make the garland. So not only did my house smell like heaven when I baked these, it smelled so delicious. We wanted to eat them, but I don't think they'd be very good with 2 cups of salt. This turned out so much better than I could have imagined, and I can't wait to use this in my kitchen this Christmas. So next we are going to make these large paper snowflakes. This is very easy. You just start out with 8 paper sacks or bags, like lunch size bags, your glue stick, some scissors, and a pencil. This couldn't be any easier, and they make those large, beautiful paper snowflakes. So you're going to start out by using your hot glue, and with the fold side up, you're going to make a T with the hot glue on each bag, and then stacking them on top of each other, each one with the hot glue in between each bag, exactly the same way with the fold side up. After you're done gluing them all together, I just flip them over and I'm going to draw whatever design you want to do for your snowflake. So I'm just going to pencil draw that on so I know exactly where to cut, and then I'm going to use my scissors and just cut out the shapes that I have drawn on each on the stack of sacks. Now, I will say, I recommend you use extremely sharp scissors because it is a little bit difficult to go through 8 bags, especially up by the fold part, not necessarily down towards the bottom, but I was able to do it. And then when you are done doing this, you just fan it out and then you're able to glue the 2 ends together and you have a beautiful, large, rustic snowflake. Now, my thought for these is either to hang them on the catwalk banister in my home. I think they just make a beautiful rustic touch, or to hang them in each of the windows with the light shining behind them. I think that they will be beautiful. You can make each one unique and do a different design for each of them.
Oh Christmas tree, thy leaves are so unchanging. Oh Christmas tree. Next,
I'm just going to do a textured wall art using a large print that I downloaded from Etsy and had printed out in a 24 by 36 size from my local Walgreens. Next, I'm going to use the matte finish Mod Podge, and I'm going to go through and paint this all over the picture. I'm going to make it very kind of textured, where it looks like it would be super textured in the picture, such as on the house. And then I'm going to kind of brush it on in uneven strokes throughout the rest of the picture just to mattify it, and it gives it more of a painting like texture.
Brings to us such joy and glee. Oh Christmas tree, such pleasure do you bring me.
The next day after this dried completely, I grabbed my 24 by 36 inch frame. This one is from Hobby Lobby. It's beautiful. It is a solid wood frame. Took it out, and I'm also taking out the glass. I'm going to lay the picture in front and the glass behind it to kind of keep it a little flatter. But I want the picture in front because I want this to be an illusion of a painting that does not have glass or a glare in front of it. And I think that this turned out perfect. First of all, I'm doing a kind of rustic cottage gingerbread-like theme in my kitchen, I believe. That is the thought right now that I'm going to be doing. And I think this picture is just perfect. And it is just a really snowy, rustic little gingerbread cottage. I will have this download linked down in the description box, but I could not be more pleased with the way that this turned out. And if you can see in these pictures, you can see where it has all of the texture and looks like a painting.
Okay, so I have done this in the past. I have this little, I think it's a 9x9 shadow box frame that I got from Michaels. And I wanted to do another picture for somewhere in the kitchen, either the coffee bar or the kitchen. I searched vintage gingerbread art, I think, on Etsy. And it was a digital download. I just downloaded it. I'm gonna print it out on this artist canvas paper. Like I said, I've done this DIY in the past. It comes with a pack of 10. So I'm gonna size it, to fit nicely in this frame. And I'm probably going to do the little frayed edges also, just to give it a little vintage touch.
I hope you guys enjoyed the way that these cottage-inspired Christmas vintage DIYs came out. I think that they looked so cute, and I hope to have another video like this coming up because there's a few different other DIYs that I want to try out. But thank you guys so much for watching. If you are new, I would love it if you would subscribe to my channel and follow me over on Instagram at Decorate with Dana. I will see you all in my next video. I hope you have a great day.